Hello, you are very welcome to my presentation called Understanding Family Learning. My name is Mary Flanagan and I work for Limerick and Clare Education and Training Board. We live in Ireland on the west coast of Europe, and in Ireland we live and work in County Clare, which is in the west coast. It's a rural county with about 110,000 people and about 10% of these are migrants. Literacy is about a lot more than reading and writing. It's about people's self-esteem and ability to function and flourish in society. At home, literacy skills are used to carry out tasks, to get jobs done, and to function as a family using a diverse set of skills. At school, literacy is focused on as an object of study using a narrower set of skills, and this is the dominant literacy in that society. Home is the first place children encounter literacy, and children can see a reason to be literate long before school begins. There can be differences between the literacy or language used at home and that used in school. Family learning is a way of valuing home literacies and culture, not just school literacy. Family learning breaks down social isolation, promotes well-being, and has many wider benefits of learning. So where did the notion of family literacy come from? Denny Taylor first coined the term family literacy in 1983, as she observed family literacy practices happening in the home during a three-year ethnographic study of six American families. She provided evidence that school experiences of literacy are influenced by individual family practices. Education means to draw out, and family learning unlocks the intergenerational potential in families. It reaches those who participate least in learning activity and who could benefit most from it. We've heard these two terms, family literacy and family learning. Family literacy has a narrower focus on the literacy and numeracy skills, improving English, maths and language of parents and child, while family learning has a wider focus on a positive learning experience with embedded literacy, numeracy and ICT skills as a natural part of each session. It develops skills and knowledge of both the parent and the child, and we use the term family learning delivering courses in Ireland.
Parents are their children's first and most important teacher. For example, in an average school week, a child in junior or senior infants only spends 12% of their time in school. The other 88% is spent at home with their parents. Learning at home with parents can be fun and easy. Children learn through play and should be given many opportunities to do this. Children learn best when they have direct experiences with learning tasks.
Rectangle.
Look for opportunities for conversations and for asking questions.
Parents are their child's first and most natural teacher. They are their experts on their children, and many parents may underestimate how important they are. In and around the home is a very valuable learning place. And one of the things that we could focus on is the everyday print that is all around us.
Print is all around us. We can see it everywhere. We can see it in magazines, symbols, letters, newspapers, logos, signs, guides, cards, leaflets, posters, menus, packages, labels, recipes, calendars. Print is everywhere. Children will learn that print carries a message and has many uses, and it is valued by all kinds of people in their life.
So why do we use family learning? Before the 60s, parents really weren't involved, certainly in the English-speaking world. Schools tended to be overcrowded. It was the tradition. Parents were not teachers, so how could they teach? During the 60s, the family background and parental involvement began to be recognised, and there was an assumption that targeted educational programmes could compensate for socio-economic disadvantage. in the English-speaking world again, during the 70s, parents were directly involved in prescriptive reading with their child, pause, prompt, and praise, and the literacy levels of parents were not taken into account. During the 80s, there was investigations into the roots of literacy and the home as a learning place. And in 2003, Charles DeForge showed that parental engagement can account for up to 20% of the difference between outcomes for pupils. While in 2018, family learning is now welcoming families to learn in a relaxed and fun atmosphere, helping to reinforce learning at home. It helps parents to reconnect to learning and transform their lives. And it allows parents to find out how their children learn and how to support them better. James Heckman, the economist and Nobel Prize winner, says that some kids win the lottery at birth, but far too many don't. And most people have a hard time catching up over the rest of their lives. The highest rate of return in early childhood development comes from investing as early as possible from birth through to age five in underprivileged families. And the focus should be on the first 5 years for the greatest efficiency and effectiveness. Programs at the boundary between non-formal and informal learning, and in particular family learning or family literacy programs, make a significant contribution to the provision of basic skills. Family Literacy Research in Ireland in 2000 published Family Literacy Practices in Education and Training Boards. There are guidelines, case studies and recommendations, and it has an up-to-date literacy review. There were 14 guidelines under three themes: taking time to think about family literacy, developing and delivering learner-centered programs, and future-proofing for flexible, responsive and appropriate family learning. So who attends family learning? Single parents, travellers, refugees, asylum seekers, migrant workers, adults with unmet literacy or language needs, long-term unemployed adults, low-income parents, grandparents, and carers or foster parents. We use an interagency approach to help reach parents. As parents with unmet literacy or language needs may not attend courses, we work with agencies that refer parents and promote our courses to their clients, such as the social care services, health service, libraries, preschools or kindergarten, and the homeschool community teacher in some designated disadvantaged primary and second level schools. And for example, migrant support groups or other community development organisations. Parents tend to be most sensitive to helping children when they are starting preschool or kindergarten, starting primary school, and then moving to second level. So it's a very good time to reach parents to encourage them to attend courses. So when does family learning happen? Generally, it happens in schools or venues near schools since COVID-19 arrived, and in community group venues. Mornings mostly for the parents of younger children, and we try to have them close to the school and at a time when children are going to the school. So for example, if the school starts at 9, the classes start from 9 to 11. Evenings then for certain courses for parents of older children start in second level, and these would start from 7 p.m. and run till 9. So how does family learning work? There are needs identified. So parents request support for a topic to the tutor or teacher. The course is then developed to suit the needs of the group in advance or when the group meets, and the tutor facilitates this group rather than teaches the group. Progression routes are offered then before the end of the course. Malcolm Knowles is the father of andragogy, or adult learning, and we use adult education methodologies. Parents and learners move from dependency to self-directedness, They draw on their prior experience for learning. They're ready to learn when they assume new social roles, for example, as a parent. They want to apply the new knowledge immediately, and the learning shifts from being subject content to problem solving. The ORAM framework was developed by Sheffield University with the Raising Early Achievement in Literacy project. Along the top, there are headings: sharing books, environmental print, that's the print that's all around us, oral language, and writing. And we in Clare added numeracy and ICT. Then along here, we have ORIM. The opportunity, for example, to share books might be at bedtime. The recognition of the child's achievement. If the parent asks, can you find any words or letters that you know, and then praises the child when they do. What is the parent and child interaction on this sharing books? Ask the child to help turn the page or talk about the favourite parts. Did you like the ending? And the modelling then is letting your child see you looking at books, magazines and newspapers, and so on for each of the other areas. And it's a framework that can allow parents to see what they're doing at home builds up literacy skills of their child, and that they play a valuable role in it. In Clare, we developed a family learning resource pack in the year 2000. It focuses on the parents of children aged 0 to 7. There's a guide for the tutor or facilitator, 6 parent booklets, and a 50-piece photo pack. Now, this is now available online for free to download, and there are 9 photographs that are out of date because of the technology that was used, but they're good for topics, drawing out conversation, and the topics include parents as national teachers, the importance of talk, why we use rhyme songs and poems, storytelling and reading together, print is all around us, everyday writing, maths in action, making a book, putting it all together. So the course is usually delivered 2 hours once a week for 6 to 14 weeks, depending on your access to a group. And we adapt the course to the needs of the group, so that if we have low literacy learners, we would be using oral exercises and an oral class more than doing more reading and writing type activities. And all our classes are free, because we're a government agency. Games are important and stressed during our resource guide, and this little video talks about Scrabble.
Playing Scrabble doesn't just build the child's vocabulary. Giving the child responsibility for calculating scores gives them the chance to practice mental maths through adding and multiplication. Even the youngest members of the family can participate by counting out the letters for each player.
What are the topics of our courses? For our migrants, they want to understand the vocabulary and how school works. We explain about the curriculum content and how to help with homework and study skills. We also promote and greater engagement with books and stories at all ages, and provide fun, positive themed learning opportunities. The early catastrophe, the 30 million word gap. US research showed that by age 3, children from monolingual privileged families have heard 30 million more words than children from monolingual welfare families. Longitudinal data on 42 families examined what accounted for enormous differences in rates of vocabulary growth. Follow-up data indicated that the 3-year-old measures of accomplishment predicted third grade school achievement. These were the number of words heard by children differs across the income groups. The average number of hours a child from a professional family has been read to is 1,200 before they start school. The average hours a child from a welfare family has been read to is 25 before starting school. So this equates, when extrapolated, to 18 months as a gap in language ability between children from welfare families and professional families when they start school. Children's academic success at age 9 and 10 can be attributed to the amount of talk they hear from birth through to starting school. The gaps widen rather than diminish over the early primary school years. And at 16 to 18 months, when children begin amassing vocabulary, word learning is significantly affected by economic background. Now, how many parents know that children at 18 months can learn 2 to 5 words a day? But the importance of reading and introducing new vocabulary and new words is very important at this point. Over the years, then, we've had requests from a charity to help with some children who were being, we'll say, left in rooms without the curtains being opened, watching TV all day. And we began a course called My Baby and Me, and to invite the parents to bring their babies with them. And we developed some topics called sharing books, plays learning, talking together with your baby, sharing songs and rhymes, the importance of routines, technology and children. The parents said, "I didn't know I am my baby's first teacher. I was waiting for him to go to school to start learning. I can see now he has already started his learning at home. I didn't realize I could do so much to support her development and how important I was as a parent. I really loved coming to the classes. I was feeling lonely before and was unsure how to deal with problems. I learned so much from this group." Later on, we developed a booklet called My Baby and Me. It has an information sheet on how to use the book, and this is available to download from clarefamilylearning.org. In this, we look at topics such as going out for a walk and what do you see. The parents' and the child's images are from photographs are placed on top, so they become a personalized book. We look at Let's Play, and we can add in the images of the children in their own photographs into the booklet as well, and we just stick them on. The importance of being face to face, the importance of touch, and learning about observing, waiting, and listening to your child, and move with me. Another resource that we developed, which is also online, is the 23 course outlines with a sample session outline for each course. There are evaluation and progression ideas and literacy and numeracy links here. Again, that's on clarefamilylearning.org. One of our Roma groups wanted to know how to help children to do well in school. So we developed a little story about a family who moved to Ennis. Their children are doing well in school and they share their tips. And this is bilingual Czech English and Slovak English. And the artwork was by children from the two schools. The launch of the booklet was very well attended. And previously, many of the families weren't coming into the school. They were afraid to come through the school door. And the attendance was erratic of the children, and the teachers were afraid the children wouldn't transfer to second level. But during this project, the attendance has improved immensely and transferred successfully to second level. So let's have a look at the variety of family learning courses in schools and community venues that we use in Clare. We have Roma fathers and older sons working together making benches. We have school gardens with the parents and child working together, learning to cook for the family in the school. Woodwork class, the parents make the bird box, the child decorates it, and both learn about the birds at home. Sit and knit classes, and you can see there's enterprise possibilities here because these are very nice presents or gifts as well as possibly for sale. Fun science, parent and child together. understanding the digestive system in a fun way. Sock puppets were created by a migrant father who attended with his son and daughter, and this brings in cultural aspects to a craft class. It's important to celebrate at the end of the course. And this is a sample of, let's say, how an introduction to a sewing class can lead on to a follow-on class where they progress onto more difficult tasks, such as learning to use a pattern, making clothes, which is a very numerical task. Sewing class can produce toys, aprons, and nowadays masks. And then a portfolio for level 3 is created with sample work. Puppets then at level 3 accreditation for use in schools and to bring home for their child. And this can encourage oral language. Webb in 2007 found that a focus on parents' involvement impacted on parents in 3 ways. They were aware of their own importance as a role model. They became aware that activities at home impact on children's achievement in school. And it had a positive impact on parents' mental health, with the added benefit of high percentage of parents continuing in education. The outcomes from family learning courses include new skills, gains in confidence and understanding, improved communication, changed behaviours and changed relationships. This is a sample evaluation sheet we use for our short courses. 3 things I've enjoyed and 3 things I would change. And then at the bottom, what I might like to learn more about. McGivney mentions, the softer outcomes of learning, such as increased confidence, appear to be key to achieving the harder outcomes desired by government funders. All the evidence indicates that they enable and facilitate educational and economic progression, especially among new and more hesitant, for example, adult literacy or family literacy learners. Now, this is finally, before we finish, just to be aware of what we do every day and how learning opportunities are possible.
Baking at home is probably one of the most fun and mathematically rich activities you can do with your children. From reading the recipe, following the instructions, recognizing numbers, you can help your child hone basic math skills by doing something as simple as counting eggs or pouring water into a measuring cup. Baking also helps a child explore different textures and encourages the use of descriptive dialogue. It creates opportunities to make estimations on quantities and gives children a sense of time when waiting for our goodies to bake in the oven.
Family Learning, clarefamilylearning.org has a section called Helping to Learn with lots of resources that we collated from across Ireland over the lockdown. We have the family learning books and 8 new short videos that you've seen some clips from that our tutors have created. And there are other resources there. And these are free to download. I have been privileged over the past 20 years working in family learning to see parents discover hope, raise their expectations, and see a different future for themselves and their family. Time and again, I see family learning benefit not only the person, but their family and the wider community. Parents become confident, succeed in finding work, and become more active citizens in society. In short, family learning works. Thank you for listening. Stay safe.